To introduce Chips, I'm just going to find the clicker. So my project is Champion Volunteers, and I'm here today to introduce Chips. I'm Rhiannon Lowe, I'm Chair of Trustees at Chips, and I'm here to ask for £4,000, or help get towards £4,000, for a volunteer coordinator. This will help Chips families, Chips children, and Chips volunteers, and it will help the sustainability of Chips going forward. So why did I get involved in Chips? This is my friend. This is about 10 years ago. And these little boys, well, that one's my son and that's her younger son, but her older son at this point in time was going to Great Ormond Street, having tests for vitamin D deficiency, rickets. He was being told all sorts of things, and eventually got a diagnosis of a cerebral palsy. But actually, a diagnosis was a relief. She knew what he was going through, and Chips was there for her. And Chips really supported her, and that's how I got involved. I went through a bit of her stresses. I don't pretend to go through as many of her stresses as she did. So Chips, what is Chips? It's a funny acronym, I know. So it's Children's Integrated Play Schemes. We currently support 220 local families and over 300 children. We provide play, fun, social opportunities for children and their families, and that provides respite for their families. We've been told in parent surveys that Chips helps the families feel less stressed, less isolated, and it's a really good thing for Chips families. So this project is Champion Volunteers. So we currently have 50 volunteers at the moment, and we want to grow that. We haven't got resource to pay lots of staff, so what we want to do is grow our volunteer network and support our volunteer network. If we grow our volunteer network, we can offer more sessions to families because we've got other resources. At our schemes, we've got space for them, we just don't have enough staff. So we can invite more families to sessions. And we've currently got a waiting list of 50 children on a waiting list, and we can use these staff and these volunteers to help reduce that waiting list. So a volunteer team leader, we haven't got one at the moment. In our office, we've got the equivalent of 1.5 FTE, and they do a fantastic job, but supporting the 50 volunteers we've got is enough work, yet alone growing it. So this is why this project would mean so much to Chips, and it would mean so much to the volunteers, like Edward, that I'm going to introduce later. It would mean so much to them, because it's proper training. We don't give training, but we want to give even better training. It's the volunteer experience. We want to champion our volunteers. You may have seen on our Facebook this week, it's been Volunteers Week, and we've been championing all of our volunteers and trying to give them exposure and trying. It's not without reason, because we hope that they'll tell their friends and encourage their friends, because we've heard that 50% of more volunteers is by word of mouth, so we're really looking at you guys. I keep looking at Edward to spread the message. So talking about Edward, he came to work with us just for 6 months doing his Duke of Edinburgh scheme. That's how we get quite a lot of our volunteers through the Duke of Edinburgh scheme. Local schools recommend them. But he's quite shy. He can talk to you about himself after this. And now he's worked, we haven't got rid of him. We still haven't got rid of him. He's hoping to become staff at Chips. And he's now doing his A-levels. So he's doing an A-level next week and he's still come here. He now wants to be a primary school teacher, and you've got university applications in for it. So I wish you well, but we don't want to lose you, so you've got to come back in the holidays and work for us. So we have a range of volunteers, and with a volunteer coordinator, we can extend that range even further. So we have sibling volunteers, which is really core to our sort of ethos. We have volunteers like Hazel. She's amazing. Hazel is just Hazel. Graham will go, Hazel is just amazing. She's a parent trustee. She's got a 14-year-old son that is mute. He doesn't talk. He's got autism. But she does she just lives fundraising. She's raised 40 grand for us in the last 3 years. She jumps off a pier with helium balloons, dressed up as a man from Up. And she's been in the newspaper recently because she's doing a world record attempt with 350 Nordic walkers. And she's invited the Prime Minister, but the Prime Minister might be a little bit busy tonight. These are my GSK work colleagues, because I don't know, I'm also a scientist, I am totally volunteer at Chips. So these are my work colleagues. We go and do mad science at Chips. We've got 20 of us going and doing mad science this year. The kids love it. It performed part of the Ofsted inspection last year, which was quite fun. But I shouldn't say it, but at work we say we go and blow the kids up. But they like it. type of opportunity that we want to go further. Fundraising, lots of fundraising opportunities. This is my son now, and he did at 10, he did a 5K swim for CHIPS. So yeah, get my whole family in. Graham, who's going to be talking next, fundraising. So I'd like to leave it on a story about Adam. This is one of our real success stories. So Adam was a child at CHIPS, he's got autism, so he started as a child at CHIPS at 3, became a volunteer at 13, and he got our award, he got in the newspaper, and now he's staff. So we've given him those skills and that confidence to actually become staff, and hopefully, you know, he's got on his CV that he works for us, and hopefully that will open even more doors. So I'd like to thank you very much for your support, and I'd like to invite my colleagues, Graham and Edward, up on stage to help me answer some questions, because I think you might want to talk to Edward.